Hi, my name is Don Russell. About 67 years ago in 1955, I was a young engineer for the B.F. Goodrich Company at their main plant office in Akron, Ohio, in tire design. We were asked to go to Texas to run some high-speed tire tests, and I was going with another two-man crew to do those 100-mile-an-hour tire tests on the public highways in Texas. However, when we got ready to go down and use the hotel in the main only place they had for a hotel, you couldn't get a room because Warner Brothers had leased the hotel for 2 months to film the movie Giant, a classic movie with Rock Hudson, Elizabeth Taylor, and James Dean. At the last minute, they allowed us to have a suite in the hotel, and we got to stay for our 3 or 4 week work exercise in the hotel with Warner Brothers staff and actors. The main actors, namely Rock Hudson and Elizabeth Taylor, stayed in homes, but the rest of them stayed in a little two-story hotel. And so in the process of getting acquainted with them, one of the people was Elizabeth Taylor's makeup man, who was fascinated by our 100-mile-an-hour tests on those highways, and we were fascinated by his movie production project about 8 miles west of Marfa in the boondocks. He invited us out to the set, and we took him up on his invitation, and one afternoon spent almost the whole afternoon as his guest at the site where they were filming a barbecue scene for the famous movie Giant. It's over a lengthy movie, but we did get to see a lot of the stars, and he offered to take our picture with some of them, namely Elizabeth Taylor. I will show you a black and white version of that one and only picture that he took with my camera with Elizabeth Taylor on the set at the barbecue scene. We have had a lot of black and white still pictures that people have looked at, and I'm going to show some of them early on here on this video, the black and white pictures that we took of various things on the set out in the Marfa area. Then I'll follow it with colored home movies that we were allowed to take on the set. Wasn't too many people visiting the set, so you had the freedom of going all over the set and doing what you please. I was amazed at that freedom. But you'll get to see some close-ups here as they arrive from Virginia, where they filmed the first part of the movie on a chartered airliner, and also some scenes as I took out on the set as they were filming that barbecue scene. Anyway, enjoy it, and thank you for watching.
There's a blue moon that's dancing across Texas, and somewhere there's fiddles.
Show some black and white pictures that I took, still pictures. Here's a sign coming into Texas that we saw, and here we are going to do 100-mile-an-hour tests. Here's a caravan arriving from Hollywood, multiple trucks to start the shooting of the Giant movie in Marfa, Texas. here's an antique car carrier that they brought their own antique cars from Hollywood. Here's a scene from my film clip of some of those antique cars they brought. And here's the set clear out 8 miles from Marfa. Clear out in the boondocks, they made a telephone pole facade in Hollywood and re-erected it out there in the middle of the scenery. Here's a gate entrance. And here's a little close-up of that false front from Hollywood. And here's one of our friends walking up towards the actual false front. Here's a scene that they made at a sighting right near the highway where we were testing tires. And there's a sound truck at that particular set. It's one of my friends from Goodrich looking at the scenery. And there we are, a picture with Rock Hudson looking out over the scene. Rock Hudson again with Elizabeth Taylor. There they are together at that sighting scene. This is a train arriving from Texas during the movie. Here's a scene showing the reserved chairs for Miss Taylor and Rock Hudson. Also in the next picture is Rock Hudson getting a little advice from George Stevens, who was in charge of the giant production. Next are 67-year-old reconstructed 8mm movies of action in Marfa and on the giant set. There's a small airport on the edge of Marfa where planes could land at originally a World War II airport. This is a charter plane arrangement coming in from Virginia, where they had filmed the first part of The Giant in the Virginia setting. The crowd out there that day was probably in the neighborhood of about 100 people or so that were invited by a newspaper release that the plane would be coming at a certain time on a certain day. Warner Brothers had their own camera, as we can see here, to take a documentary picture of the whole giant production. That's their cameraman. This is the airline for the Cross Texas Airways. Big airliners don't normally land on these strips, but here it is coming into Marfa. And they're circling Marfa in order to show the crew, the cast, what Marfa looks like and where the scenery is at for the setting out in the boondocks. Here the plane is coming up right in front of where we were standing. We got a pretty good view. This airliner was a propeller plane, which in 1955 was the normal first liner. They're coming off of temporary stands. They had to build these stands in order to de-embark the crew. And here we get Rock Hudson and Elizabeth Taylor coming down that temporary ramp. There's Rock Hudson. Elizabeth's right behind him. I had a pretty good view here, almost too close. I particularly noticed in these scenes here, there's a little girl behind them, and she was enjoying every moment of the being that close to a couple of real well-known movie stars. You'll see her pop up in the background. This is their first look at Marfa, Texas. They gave them those hats before they deboarded. And they're seeing this 100-person crowd greeting them to the movie set town of Marfa, which is a small one traffic light town. This is a cocktail party the night they arrived on the airplane right outside our window in the hotel. The highway patrol was guiding traffic away from the site of a filming in order that they didn't interrupt it. This is one of their first shots. This is a shot of a train arriving in the movie from Virginia with a new bride and groom on it for their Texas ranch. They had placed their change clothes. They had the old cars that they had brought in from Hollywood, putting up new signposts for the position. They also had big fans to induce high wind streams with making a windy arrival there in Texas. These fans had tumbleweeds that had been selected, they threw in front of it. There's Elizabeth Taylor giving an autograph to one of the girl fans who's out on the set looking just as we were. Rock Hudson and Elizabeth had a little bit of fun on the side in between breaks as they had enjoyed each other's company. Sound truck for the movie recording. Here's one of the wind machines up. Here's George Stevens talking to Rock Hudson. George Stevens was in charge of the production. He was the director in charge. There's Elizabeth Taylor. Now there's going to be a doubler looking just dressed like her getting a wind blast from those wind machines. This was not Elizabeth, but it was her double. And they were really giving her some real treatment. This was a rival from the Virginia on the rail car. They must have leased this car from the railroad. Here's Rock Hudson and Elizabeth Taylor looking over the set. There's some of their antique cars that they brought in on those car carriers from California. And there's a set behind it, artificial backing. More pictures of the same cars. There's a scene during the barbecue scene in the movie, and this is where Elizabeth Taylor does a fainting spell in front of a calf's head on a table there for the barbecue. There's Jane Withers, Elizabeth Taylor. Elizabeth Taylor had this same dress on in a shot that I got taken with her for a black and white shot, which you'll see here comes up right now. This was a black and white shot, one shot deal by her makeup man with my camera on the same set that you've seen in that barbecue group. There's the dealership for the Goodrich company, and that's where our tires were processed for using. This is our 100 mile an hour test on the open roads of Texas. This way out probably 20 miles from town where we did this, quite a quiet road and going to nowhere almost. We're changing the tire. One tire is changed in the passenger side that is inflated to normal inflation, and the other three tires are inflated to maybe 100 pounds so that they won't blow. These treads come off. The tires don't actually blow off, but the rubber gets warmed up from the flexing at that speed, and the rubber comes off. Very few of them went 100 miles at 100 miles an hour. We had our competitors' tires also. These were brought down from Ohio. This is part of our crew changing the tire. Get the jack out. Go up, get ready, put another tire on. Race driver helps, and then he'll take off with that car and do another test for another 100 mile for that particular tire. There he goes again, flying down the road at 100 miles an hour is pretty quick. Here's a train we saw coming down there. Sometimes we'd pass this train twice when we did a U-turn and went back on part of the trail. At 100 miles an hour, you can pass a train twice. Another scene from the faint scene in the barbecue part of the movie. And there's Rock Hudson getting a Texas suntan. You get up close, as you can see here, they did not. We had all kind of freedom to mill around the set. They were taking a break in between shoots here and talking to each other just as anybody else would be doing, having a good time taking this break. As you can see, we were allowed to mill around and just get as close as we wanted to, which surprised me. Some girls from town watching the same shooting that we were. That's a Texas theater where they did their offshoots from sampling. Goodrich dealership, Paisano Hotel, which they was leased by Warner Brothers for the 2 month period, and where we stayed. We had our own private room. And there's James Dean and Elizabeth Taylor. This is a Warner Brothers picture that I got, but he came in late to the shooting. But he was sure something different. This is a picture of Jane Withers. Jane Withers was a child movie star, and her dad worked for Goodrich, and so we had a special view with her that Warner Brothers took this particular picture. That's my other two buddies on my tire testing crew, and in the background in the checkered shirt and the black bag is Elizabeth Taylor's makeup man. There's autographs. We had autographs that we got in a pocketbook we bought in the store, and pretty well got all the autographs, not knowing that James Dean didn't give autographs, but he gave me an autograph and found out these autographs today is worth about $20,000 because he just didn't give autographs. I sold this one in 1985, the whole collection, for $500 at a New York auction.
There's a new star that's shining across Texas.
Elizabeth Taylor was 23 in 1955 when the film was shot. Rock Hudson was 30, James Dean was 24, and I was 27. Heart of mine is growing restless. Elizabeth Taylor would be 90 if she was living today. Rock Hudson would have been 97, James Dean 91. Elizabeth Taylor died at 79, Rock Hudson at 60. James Dean died at 24 in a car crash in California before the movie was released, and I'm 93 now.
There's a new star that's shining across Texas. Only heaven.